Nice view. Hello there. Orb of Ocean 94. Which one is 94? Miss Maritos. Okay. Just three rooms. Oh. Duh. Can I talk to him? Thompson. Oh, here for sightseeing? Kavaro is the perfect place for it. Please enjoy the arts of Kavaro before going home. I think I talked to him, but Stanley, yeah. This is what talks about the swamp, right? Yeah. You're looking around this place. Oh, wait. I talked to them, right? Yeah. Oops. Didn't mean to do that a second time. Okay. Being very thorough. So it just ends over here. I did see some kind of weapon shop, an item shop. That must be up here somewhere then. Well, I think they're this way. Or not. Oh yeah, here we go. East says, the people in Kavaro are very proud. Of course, women are no exception. For me, it's better to get more response to some degree when I flirt with girls. You like to get a response, huh? Okay. Panacea potion. Universal cure that works on all negative effects. I got four of them. I don't remember seeing Panacea Potion. Sure, we can't have too many of them. We can go back there, but there's nothing there, right? Oh no, we can't. He's got these boxes piled. Never mind. What's this place? Esha says, my brother is a big fan of Diva Wendy. I think he's too into her. He must really like her. Don't blame you. The rabbit ears are really cute. where's that weapon shop? That's the problem. I see things, I pass by, and then I forget where they were. That's the International Theater. I'm passing by it, not going in. It's a self-fulfilling prophecy. I have a feeling once I go in there, a whole bunch of stuff is going to start happening. So I'd rather explore the city first. Ah, there's a weapon shop. A warrior's severing sword. Long sword with a flame-like wavy blade. Produces reliable cuts with experience. What does that mean? Like, do we have enough experience to make reliable cuts? That's my question. Yew bow. Bow made of yew tree, curved in the shape of letter C and easy to aim. Okay, let's get the yew bow. Oh! For McBain, I don't know what he's using. Shadow glove. Fighter glove. I don't know what he has. He's not in our party. Medium shield. Large shield that covers the entire upper body. Sufficient protection. Heavy. Okay, medium shield. So I have to remember to come back here with Grandpa McBain. Oh, it's so weird just seeing two people. Alright. Okay. So switching from warrior shield to medium shield. You think warrior shield would be better than medium shield? It just sounds more impressive. And the U-bow for Una. Well, her attack goes way up. And defense, 1 point. Alright, so let's sell these two things. Exchange. Warrior shield. And blizzard bow. And I still have the spell book and hunter book. Whatever book I sold by mistake and couldn't get back. I think it was the sorcerer's book. But I died. After that, I had to record 3 episodes over again. And when I recorded them over, I tried to, you know, do everything as I had done before. But I did leave out selling the sorcerer's book. Forgive me. No chest back here, right? Does this go somewhere? Oh. Now let's walk around this big building. I'm not sure if there's anything else to see. Oh. Oh, he's zoned through. Oh, okay. Alright, let's go in the International Theater, because hopefully I didn't miss anything, but Globe Theater. Una says, Forte, this voice is... Yeah, it's Miss Wendy, he says. They are busy practicing, says Forte. Una says, look, Mr. Balthazar is here too. He is smashing those piano keys. Balthazar says, you're one of a kind, Wendy. I totally listened to you as if in a trance, even though it was just practice. It's because you play my accompaniment very well. Far from it. Oh? We've been spotted. You are Forte and Una? How are you? Says Forte. It's good to see you again, Una says. Long time no see, says Diva Wendy. Welcome to the Kavaro International Theater. Oh, there's Wolf saying, who are those kids? Theodora says, why don't you introduce them to us? You can't have such cute friends all to yourself. Wendy says, they are the McBain Company. I met them at Riatom Island. The McBain Company? Says Wolf. The ones who beat you at the audition there? Balthazar says, yes, they are the little musicians for the company. The little musicians? Theodora says, these are the ones... How do you do? I'm Theodora. I play the cello. Nice to meet you, says Forte. This is Wolf, the violinist. Wolf says, I'm surprised. They are really children. Wendy says, Wolf, that was a rude thing to say. They are respectable performers with talent. Yeah, children. The audition of Riatom Island is nothing but a contest held by the amateurs, says Wolf. Okay, now you're being rude. Excuse me. If you have complaint, let me hear you perform. Can boys and girls of the McBain Company play for us? Forte says, but so sudden. Why are you challenging them? Asked Theodora. I'm so sorry. Wolf has never won Balthazar on contests. He must have been very vexed that someone else beat Balthazar. Shut up. Balthazar says, well, let's leave it at that. I guess they're in the middle of sightseeing in Kavaro. We shouldn't cut in anymore. Have fun in Kavaro, says Wendy. Okay. Forte says, the next year's final contest is going to be held here, right? I don't know why, but I'm starting to get nervous. You're gonna be alright, Forte. Oh, she's coming back. Theodora. By the way, if you want to see the scenery of Kavaro, you should go up on the roof. You can view the whole city from there. Oh, good. So maybe we could see if we missed anything. The roof, says Forte. Una says, do you want to go up? Yes, we do. Oh, there's some people hanging out. Oh, that's a second floor. I like the sound of our footfalls on the heavy carpeting. So we can't get up on the stage, right? There's no way. Oh, we can. I play the piano like a maestro. Boom, 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 boom. Hi! We come to talk some more. Wolf says, only the selected people among all the musicians get the privilege to stand on the honorable stage of the International Theater. Well, we were just standing on it, so too bad. Even the backstage is not somewhere kids can hang out. Don't disturb the rehearsals, okay? Well, I'm gonna hang out on the stage for a while just because you said that. Theodora says, many of the musicians for the International Theater are graduates from the music school of Cantus. To tell you the truth, I'm also among them. Really? Says Forte. So you're senior to Schuber. Have you been to the music school? She asks. Una says, we just stopped during our tour. We were also with Principal Forgeon at the party in Riatom Island. Oh, really? I'm a direct pupil of Principal Forgeon. It's good to know he as well. A direct pupil. Balthazar says, how is Kavaro? Are you having a good time sightseeing? You don't deserve an answer. Wendy says, President Miratos is dying to meet you all. She's in the second floor of the inn, so please go visit her. She is not. We were just there. Maybe now she is. Oh, that just goes down here. Who are these people? Nor says Stardust Cantata is said to be the dream opera. It's because a satisfying performance has never been done since it requires top-notch talent on the part of both the singer and musicians. But I think we can anticipate a good performance this time. It will be good. Ooh, a chest. Ruji says, I heard that the special concert was planned by Mayor DeMille and Miss Maritos. They seem to be fighting all the time, but actually they make a good team. I heard they stopped fighting, yeah. Bran says, all the musicians who gather here in the International Theater are top-notch. But especially among them, Kavaro Trio is supremely gifted. I would love to catch up with them no matter what. Orb of Ocean 95. Items. With the image of Ms. Marito shouting. I gotta see that, actually. I don't think I've ever seen her shout. I like how it's like kind of like animated, two frames if you got. I am Ms. Maritos. Now die. Oh. I'm standing on the stage. I'm doing it for Wolf. Interesting how the stage is, like, just on the same level as these floors here. So all there is these two stairs up, right? Yeah. This goes to the roof. Oh. To another floor. Wow. Oh wow, we got, like, grand seats here. A lot of stairs. Well, there's the box office theater right here. And now, your feature presentation. No one on this level, but there is a chest. 106. Orb of Ocean 106. Diva Wendy smiling. Stairs are really confusing. We're on this. What about the other stairs? Back there, I thought we were gonna get to that. The view is great, says Forte. The breeze feels nice, Una says. Fine weather and a nice breeze, says Forte. I'm getting sleepy. Forte gave a big yawn. It's been a while since we've been alone together last, says Una. Poor Una. Oh yeah. I think this is a great chance. Well, it's good to be alone once in a while, isn't it? I know. If Grandpa's with us, we can't take time to look around. That's not what I mean. It's almost time to go meet with Grandpa. Already? What should I do? Huh? Forte? What? Oh, the girl with the black hair. That lady, says Forte. She is the lady we saw by the lakeside, says Una. I think her name was Aria. Oh yeah, I forgot that. She gonna sing? She gonna sing in there? Nope, she's gonna leave. She's gone, says Forte. Forte, look! Oh! Here's what's-his-name. Captain... Forte says, that's Numerose's... Yeah, that's Captain Palman, who was looking for Aria. Thank you, Una. Can't remember anyone's name. But he's more like following after her. It's disturbing, says Forte. Yeah. So I thought we were going to get really a good view of the whole city, like, I mean, Forte and Una did, but we did not. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. Yeah, press the other way to go, continue. So what about the stairs here? It doesn't go anywhere, does it? So like, private balcony? Just trying to follow along. It doesn't look like there's any way up there. I mean, unless that is a way up. And we have to get from the roof. But this is another stairs. Maybe this goes to the other side of the roof? It dies in this chest. I love this place. It's like a dungeon and a city. Orb of Ocean 70. That's all we're finding is Orb of Oceans. Not anything really useful. It's cool to get him, though. Sid Balthazar. Yeah. And what about this side? This other roof, which is even higher. I don't know how to get there. Oh, I hate that. Because you're pressing the up button. If you keep pressing the up button, you go back in. So you have to go up and then down. It's a very delicate operation. Okay, now we have to get back down somehow. And we can't jump. If this was some kind of 3D game, Elder Scrolls, Cyberpunk, whatever, I would just jump down. Oh, here's a... Here we go. I wonder if we can talk to these people about... Ask them about Aria. I don't like him very much. No, I don't... I guess we're going to the second floor of the inn to talk to Miss Meritos. Oh, we can just drop down like that. I didn't know we could do that. Bloop. Keep trying. Just want to see if anyone has anything to say about Aria. Yeah, you just missed her. She didn't sing. Where did she run to? To the swamp? Down to the swamp. There's the inn. Okay, so maybe we'll go... Ah, says Una. Hi, you two, says McBain. Ms. Meritos says, Forte, Una, how are you doing? Ah, Ms. Meritos, long time no see, says Una. Yeah, how have you been? How was the sightseeing in Kavaro? The city is so big that I'm impressed. Forte says, I was overwhelmed by the International Theater. I assume you already heard from Mayor DeMille, but we are getting the project of the concert rolling together. We already printed the tickets for the first day. Here are for you. Here they are for you. They receive concert ticket of Stardust Cantata. Wow, thank you, says Una. I asked Mr. McBain if you guys could perform at the International Theater, but I got a stout refusal from him. Yeah, I don't know why. We keep winning everywhere, but we can't win here. These kids still lack experience, McBain says. The reason why we could win the audition at Riatom Island is because we chose the right piece by Leon to play. Okay, so just choose the right piece again. Don't play it down, says Maritos. No, it's not that at all. You're so stubborn. Well, then we have to wait till next year's final contest to see Forte perform here. Don't give me pressure. I get nervous, says Forte. Forte, hang in there, Una says. Woof! Squeak! Maritos says, haha, you gotta do nothing but work hard. Anyway, I have some business to take care of, so please excuse me. Please make yourself at home. Are we gonna join back up? She looks busy, says Forte. Speaking of the Maritos group, McBain says, it's a big company enough to hold out against Rish. No wonder she is always busy. I hanker for a powerful woman, says Una. Really? Okay, maybe she's no longer interested in Forte. Gonna play for the other side. McBain says, well, we better get going too. All right, says Forte. Are we gonna perform in this city? No, we're gonna leave it till later. They were just over this. Miss Maritos just told about the lightning shrine near the city. If my hunch is right, we will find a resonance stone there. The lightning shrine, says Una. It does sound like a resonance stone could be hidden there. Really? Says Forte. Where's the map? Where? Let's check it on the map. Why don't we check it now? Says McBain. I think that's what Forte is saying. Let's see. McBain spread magic map. Spinning cave. Oh, that sounds wonderful. So this is... wait. The swamp and... there. Alright, so we're gonna end up going through the swamp. There's a blinking in the south side of Kavaro. There it is, says Una. It's exactly as Miss Maritos said, McBain says. This must be the lightning shrine in the swamp. Let's head to the swamp right away, says Forte. Woof! Eep! Forte and Una join with McBain. What about our pets? Oh, I almost forgot to tell you something, Grandpa. What is it? When I was sightseeing with Una, we went up on the roof of the International Theater. From there, we saw Aria. Forte told McBain about what they saw from the rooftop of the International Theater. Yes, he just did that. Captain Palman. Oh, he just threw in that detail. I bet he was ordered to capture that girl from a superior officer. Una says, come to think of it, a guy on the warship we saw in Polka was saying something like, leave no stone unturned in search of her. Is she wanted by Numero's Empire? Asked Forte. She didn't look like she was a bad person at all. That can't be true, says McBain. I don't believe she did anything awful. How can you say that? Asked Forte. Because she's too beautiful. Really? A person could look like anyone. And turn around and slice your throat. Or give you $100. You never know what they're gonna do. What kind of reason is it? Says Forte. Good reason. Why? Says Forte. Just because. Huff. Why are you guys competing over stupid things? Says Una. I thought we were on our way to search for a resonance stone. Alright, Doggy joined up. Enora says, I bought the concert ticket. I did it for Wendy. I will allow the snobbish performance if they will add more to Wendy's voice. I've been watching her since her debut. I can't miss the concert. Don't you think President Maritos is cool? A working woman should be like her. You're the McBain Company. I heard a lot about you from President Maritos. She was bragging about the troubadours who beat Diva of Kavaro and Pianist Prodigy. You're not performing at the International Theater? I would love to hear it. Yeah, we gotta end up performing there. The members of Kavaro Trio are top-notch among the young performers. And this time they're performing with Diva Wendy. Anyone who isn't excited for this is crazy. I bought a concert ticket as well. I asked Ms. Maritos to get one for me. Let's look at our ticket. Concert ticket. Ticket to Stardust Cantata performed by first-class musicians in Kavaro. First class. Maritos up here? Mr. McBain, long time no see. Oh, you're Professor Musol of the music school. Thank you for the other day. I didn't expect to see you again. I'm in here in Kavaro to study as a music teacher. Sir, how's Schubert doing? Says Forte. Is he still making pepper bombs? Why do you call her sir? Schubert has settled down a lot after that incident, as has been studying seriously compared to the past. Of course, he is still making pepper bombs, though. Haha, that's Schubert all over, says Una. If you have a chance to come back to Cantus, please stop up at the school. Schubert would love to see you. How long are you going to stay here, Professor? Says McBain. Well, I'm planning to return after I attend as many concerts as possible until I get sick of them, so I'll be here a while. Oh, you know, I somehow got a ticket to see Stardust Cantata. There's no way I would leave here without listening to Stardust Cantata. She somehow got a ticket. Yeah, there she is. The Maritos group is dealing widely from entertainment promotion to food distribution and vending. I don't mean to brag about this, but the arms dealers and the tool shops are affiliated with the Maritos group. Other than that, we invested money to build the inn by the lakeside. We are proud of the Maritos group, and it is my reason for living. Wow. Your reason for living. Kind of putting all your eggs in one basket. Well, now that we have Grandpa back and animals, we need to go back to the weapon shop and see if the glove he has can be upgraded. Shadow glove. There was two gloves there. I don't remember what they were called. And maybe we'll try that sword for him. For Forte. And we gotta walk around and talk to everyone all over again, because now McBain's with us and some of them will talk to McBain and McBain will say stuff, so. And then we're heading to the swamp to find another resonance stone. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.